So this is the first study where that actually compares bone strength in prehistoric women to those of actually living women. We have some data from living men, but nobody had ever scanned any women to provide a comparative data set. And this matters because men and women don't build bone in the same way to loading. A lot of people forget that the skeleton is actually alive. It's a tissue that responds to loading, it responds to what you're doing in your life, and it will change accordingly. So if you, for example, are a runner and you're exerting a lot of loading on your legs, your bones will respond by either adding more bone or moving bone around so that it's strong enough for that particular sort of activity that you're doing. When we look at athletes or living people where we actually know what they're doing, we can start to link characteristics in their bones to what they're actually doing in their life. So that when you just have a skeleton from someone who lived thousands of years ago, we can start to look for similarities in the shape and strength of the bone with a living person, and then work our way backwards to interpret how that prehistoric person might have been loading their bone. I recruited from the Cambridge University Women's Boat Club because I wanted a sport that loads the arms. I had a lot of runners and soccer players, but they're not really doing anything with their arms. The good thing about rowing is it's not really high impact, like a sport like tennis would be on the arms, but it is really repetitive and really labor intensive. There's a huge amount of muscle force to row. Their training volume was twice as high as the other sports I had. So what we found was really, really strong arm bones in prehistoric women compared to all of the living women, even the rowers. Well, we think the main activity that they would have been doing that is contributing to these really strong arms is processing grain. This is when you'd have been farming by hand, essentially. So there's no plow yet. They're planting by hand, they're making grain by hand. This would have involved hours of manual labor. This was done by hand with what's called a saddle kern. It involves kind of grinding the grain against a stone with another stone. That's really, really repetitive and labor intensive. In modern traditional farming societies, this is usually women that do this, and it can account for up to 5 hours a day of manual labor for them. I think a lot of the time we underestimate women's loading, women's behaviors, because women's bones don't respond to loading in as extreme a way as men's do. So often trends in men look really exciting, and women are more difficult to interpret what we're seeing because women do so many different things in their daily life. So what was really great was being able to highlight the thousands of years of really intense manual labor that women were doing. And it's that manual labor that really provided the driving force, allowing for the development and expansion of production economies once we start farming. We wouldn't have this sort of expansion that we saw without those sort of unseen hours of women's work.